Dear students, welcome to physics class. I am Dr. J.C. Babu, Assistant Professor of Physics from Vivekananda Government Degree College. Today, we will discuss about nanomaterials and nanotechnology. Nowadays, nanotechnology is playing a significant role, so that we will discuss about what is nanotechnology, and what is nanoscience and nanomaterials. For this, I am going to share my PowerPoint presentation. So, in this PowerPoint presentation, today's topics are basic concepts of nanoscience and nanotechnology, quantum wire, quantum well, and quantum dot, properties and technological advantages of nanomaterial, and applications of nanomaterial we will discuss. So, what is nano? We will discuss. Nano is very small size. It is compared to meter, it is 10 power minus 9 meter. Means 1 billion part of a meter. If you divide a meter into 1 billion parts, in that one part is called a nanometer. It is very, very small unit. Is called a small unit in length, nanometer. 10 power minus 10 meters is 1 angstrom unit. This is almost all nanometer is very close to that 10 power minus 9 meter. So for comparison purpose, if you see, if you want to know what is the nanometer size, the width of the average ear is 1 lakh nanometer. See, human blood cells are 2000 to 5000 nanometer long. A standard DNA has a diameter of 2.5 nanometer and a line of 10 hydrogen atoms. If you place a 10 hydrogen atoms in a line, that is 1 nanometer. So that this is a very, very small length if you compare to with the meter, 1 by 10 power to the power of 9 meter is equal to 1 nanometer, that is equal to 10 power minus 9 meters is equal to 1 nanometer. So here, nowadays, everywhere we are using the nanotechnology in medicines, in research, in military, wherever we are observing, the nanotechnology is a widely spread technology nowadays. So the concepts of nanotechnology, nanomaterials, finds the uses in healthcare, especially in cancer, treatment of cancers, or in electronics, even in cosmetics, textiles, information technology, environmental protection, even more in military, medicines, so that everywhere we can see these uses of nanotechnology. For this, one thing, investigations at the nano level are occurring in a variety of academic fields, not only in physics, but also includes chemistry, biology, everything. The researchers are focusing about the nanotechnology. So that the importance of nanotechnology and is very vast and very important is there. First of all, we would like to know what is nanomaterials. As I said, the size of the material is about 2 nanometers, then that materials are called the nanomaterials. Usually the size should be in between 1 to 100 nanometer is considered as the nanomaterials. The material size is between 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer, then the materials are said to be nanomaterials or nanophase. Nanomaterials or nanophase materials are the materials which are made of grains that are about 100 nanometer in a diameter and contains less than few 10,000 of atoms. And this is nanomaterial, and it's the science dealing with the nanomaterials is called the nanoscience. But nanotechnology comprises the emerging application of the nanoscience. The technology is the application of the science. Now we are using that technology, which we are developed based on the nanoscience. So technology in existing area of scientific development, which promises more for less. It offers ways to create smaller, cheaper, lighter, and faster devices that can do more and clever things. We use raw materials and consume less energy. So that due to these advantages, we are using the nanotechnology in everywhere. These are smaller, cheaper, lighter, and faster devices that can do more clever things using less raw materials and consume less energy. The material size in nano, that's why they use the less energy, and they move fast, and faster devices we can develop by using nanotechnology. And the weight also lighter, and also these are the cheaper. Due to these advantages nowadays, and they focus exact targets, so that this nanotechnology is a very important branch that we have to focus on. This a branch of science and engineering devoted to design and production of extremely small electronic devices and circuits built from individual atoms and molecules. It's a technology dealing with the matter of molecular size, scale of nanometers. So that nanotechnology also defined as use of technology to create materials on an atomic scale. In real world example, there are nano coatings which can repel dirt and reduce the need for harmful cleaning agents or prevent the spread of hospital-borne infections. So that if you use, nowadays we are seeing the coronavirus. If we are with nano coating material, the infections we can avoid. By using the spread of corona, we can avoid the infections if you use the nano coated materials or nano coated coats like that. So that nano coatings which can repel dirt and reduce the need for harmful cleaning agents, prevent the spread of hospital borne infections. New generations hip implants can be made more body friendly. Before that, they are not suitable for body. Now by using the hip implants, this can be body friendly because they have nanoscale topography that encourages acceptance of the cell in their vicinity. Moving on to more complex products, good examples of the applications of nanotechnology is a mobile phone. which has changed dramatically in a few years, becoming smaller and smaller. In the years, 10 years back, the mobile phone or cell phone is so large. Now it's a slim phone, slim body is coming. It's coming that which has changed dramatically in a few years, becoming smaller and smaller, while productively growing clever and faster and cheaper. So this is because of the nanotechnology. Nanomaterials exist in nature in the form of biological materials. Already nano size materials already there in nature in the form of biological materials are a byproduct of human activities. For example, hemoglobin is a 5.5 nanometers in diameter, and biological ion channels can be as small as few tenths of a nanometer. Natural nanomaterials such as smoke from fire and sea spray exist in the air around us. So that in nature, nano-sized materials are there in nature around us. And man-made nanomaterial byproducts include automobile exhaust and welding fumes. Scientists have already copied the nanostructure of several natural items, including the lotus leaf, to create water repellent surfaces being used to make a stain-proof clothing and spider silk, which is naturally reinforced with the nano crystal. So that these are the general and the examples around us. If you see the size of the material in three-dimensional, two-dimensional and one-dimensional. The size of the nanomaterial in three-dimensional is quantum well. If it is in two-dimensional, it is a quantum wire. It is in only in dot, it is called the quantum dot. So that when the size of the dimension of material is continuously reduced from large and microscopic size, such a meter or centimeter, to a very small size, the properties remain the same at first, then small changes begin to occur until finally when the size drops below the 100 nanometer, dramatic changes in properties can occur. So the size is decreasing. When the size reaches to below the 100 nanometer, the properties are drastically changing. The changes are occurring in the properties of the matter. If one dimension is reduced to the nano range, while the other dimensions remain large, then we obtain the structure known as the quantum well. Only one dimension is in nano size, the other length and width is in big size, then we can call as a quantum well. If the two dimensions are so reduced and one remain large, the resulting structure is referred as a quantum wire. In the extreme case of this process of size reduction, in which all three dimensions reach the low nanometer range, is called the quantum dot. This we can see in this next picture. See here, this is the bulk material. The width is large, height is large, and length is also large. Three dimensions are large. When you reduce the two dimensions, and two dimensions are large, but one dimension is so small in nanometer size, this is called the well. But in the two dimensions are reduced to nano size, only the height is in large, this is called the wire. And here the three dimensions are reduced to nano size, this is called the dot. So that this is the how the nano size particle we can produce from the bulk material. This is the example for the example to understand the what is the nano size material. If three dimensions are in nano size, that is dot. two dimensions in nano size, that is wire, only one dimension in nano size, that is well. So this is bulk material. If you see in this circular form, this is well and this is wire and this is dot. So the word quantum is associated with the above three types of nanostructures, because the changes in properties arise from the quantum mechanical nature of physics in domain of the ultra small. The figure represents the process of diminishing the size for the case of rectilinear geometry and the corresponding reduction in curvilinear geometry. The conduction electrons are confined in narrow dimensions. Such a configuration is referred as quantum well. A quantum wire is a structure such as a copper wire that is a long in dimension but has a nanometer size as its diameter. In this case, the electrons move freely along the wire but are confined in the transverse directions. The quantum dot may have the shape of the tiny cube, a sharp cylinder or sphere with low nanometer and dimensions. So these are the example for the quantum well and quantum wire and quantum dot. So quantum dot is a tiny cube in all dimensions or in nano size. So nano manufacturing. So there are two types of manufacturers methods are there. One is bottom-up approach and another one is the top-down method. So bottom-up approach is one approach to the preparation of nanostructure called the bottom-up approach, is to collect, consolidate and fashion individual atoms and molecules into the structure. This is carried out by a sequence of chemical reactions controlled by a series of catalysts. This is a process that is a widespread in biology, where, for example, catalysts called the enzymes assemble amino acids to construct living tissues that forms and support the organs of the body. And top-down method, the opposite approach to the preparation of nanostructure is called the top-down method, which starts the large scale object or pattern and gradually reduces its dimensions. This can be accomplished by a technique called the lithography, which shines radiations through a template on a surface coated with a radiation sensitive resist. This resist then removed and surface is chemically treated to produce the nano structure. Properties of nanomaterials. The properties of nanomaterials are not always well characterized, and they call for the risk assessment of possible exposure arising during the manufacture and use. The unique properties are, generally they have very high magnetoresistance, they have large melting points, high solid state phase transition pressure, lower debye temperature, high self diffusion coefficient. They have high catalytic activity and lower ferroelectric phase transition temperature. Variation of physical properties with size. It is well established that mechanical, electrical, optical, chemical, semiconducting and magnetic properties of the material depend strongly upon the size and the arrangement of the constant clusters and grain. So depending on the size, the properties of the nanomaterials are changing. And number one, electron affinities and chemical properties. Variation in electron properties with size occurs only when there is a variation in inner particle spacing and geometry. The size is reduced from the bulk, electronic bands in materials become narrower and the delocalized electronic states are transformed to more localized molecular bonds. So when the size is reducing, these delocalized electronic states are transforming into the more localized molecular bonds, so that these electronic properties such as affinities and chemical properties are changing. Variation of electronic properties with size occurs there is a variation in interparticle spacing and geometry. As the size is reduced from bulk, the electron bands in metals become narrower and the delocalized electronic states are transformed to more localized molecular bonds. You see the graph between the cluster size and number of atoms and electronic bonding energy. So ionization potential and reactivity of plane clusters as function of size. The ionization potential are higher at smaller size than the bulk at the bulk work function. So that here the ionization potential is higher. The large surface to volume ratio and the variation in geometry and electronic structure as have a strong effect on catalysis properties. Magnetic properties. Nanoparticles, magnetic and even non-magnetic solids exhibit a totally new class of magnetic properties. So this here, this is the bulk material, this is the cluster. So the bulk material is paramagnetic, is ferromagnetic. This is ferromagnetic in cluster, it is super paramagnetic. This is also super magnetic. This is paramagnetic in bulk, but when in nano cluster, it is a ferromagnetic. So that the behavior of very small particles of various metals will changing when the they are changing their size from bulk to nano cluster. The ferromagnetic and anti-ferromagnetic multilayers have been found to exhibit GMR, gauge magnetoresistant. Small particles differ from the bulk in that these atoms will have low air coordination number. So that from the figure, it is inferred that small particles are more magnetic than the bulk material. And changing the bulk magnetic moment versus coordination number. The coordination number is increasing, the magnetic moment is decreasing. This is the graph between melting point of gold as a function of the grain size. So that the grain size is less, the melting temperature is less. If the grain size is more, the melting point of bulk material is increasing. Mechanical behavior. From the figure, it is evident that melting point reduction is not really significant until the particle size is less than 10 nanometer. So less than 10 nanometer is not significant. After that only, this is increasing. And nano phase metals with their exceptionally small grain size are found to be exceptionally strong. So the size is small, then there are nanophase materials with the small grain size are exceptionally they are strong. It is because clusters and grains in the nanophase material are mostly free from dislocations. They are free from dislocations. And the variation of hardness with the diameter of copper nanocrystal is shown in the figure. This is the hardness with the size. From the figure, it is revealed that when the grain size was 50 nanometer in diameter, the copper was twice as hard as usual. See here, this is 0.5, but when it is comes to 50 nanometer, it has come to 1. So double is the hardness of the this one. Thus the material in nano phase has very high strength and super hardness. So the nano materials are very hard compared to the size and they are super harder compared to the normal size. There are risk management. Existing risk assessment methods are generally applicable to the nanomaterials, but specific aspects related to nanomaterials need more development. They include methods for both estimating exposure and identifying hazards. The highest potential risks come from free insoluble nanomaterials, either dispersed in a liquid or as a dust. Risk management requires a detailed examination of properties, including particle size, surface area, stability, surface properties, solubility, chemical reactivity. So now we will see the applications. As I said, there are so many applications of nanomaterials, including all areas, so that nanotechnology offers opportunity in creating new features and functions. It is already providing the solutions to many long-standing medical and social and environmental problems. Not only in the medical, it is also in useful and social and environmental problems also we are solving using the nanotechnology. And also using this technology, we have to find out the solution for the present situation, that is like corona or COVID-19 situation, so that researchers are using this technology also to prevent the this life of infections. Because of its potential, and nanotechnology is a global interest, it is attracting more public funding than any other area of technology. Estimated euros of 3.8 billion euros in worldwide in 2005. It's also the one area of research that is truly multidisciplinary in nature. Nanotechnology is a multidisciplinary in nature. It combines not only one science, it combines more than one science, like physics and medical, chemistry and biology, physics and biology, like that nanomaterial research is going on. So technological advantages of nanotechnology and nanomaterial. The improved transportation. Today, most airplanes are made from metal, despite the fact that diamond has strength to weight ratio over 50 times that of aerospace aluminium. So that this we are using. Diamond is expensive. It is not possible to make it in the required shapes and it shatters. Nanotechnology will let us inexpensively make shatterproof diamond in exactly the shapes we want. So that by using this one, we use in aeroplanes. And nanotechnology will dramatically reduce the cost and increase the capabilities of spaceships and spaceflight. So that the capability of spaceships and spaceflight, so they decrease the cost and increase the capability. And the The strength to weight ratio and the cost of components are absolutely critical to the performance and the economy of spaceships. With nanotechnology, both of these parameters will be improved. Nanotechnology will also provide extremely powerful computers with which to guide both those ships and wide range of other activities in space. Atom computers. Nowadays, you see the size of the computer is drastically decreasing from desktops to laptop, laptops to tab and smartphone. And coming days, the size of the computer may be in atomic scale. So that in a coming days, we will get the atom size computer that is called the nano computers. So that today computer chips are made using the lithography, literally stone writing. If the computer hardware revolution is to continue at its current phase, in a decade or so, we will to move behind lithography to some new post-lithographic manufacturing technology. Ultimately, each logic element will be made from just a few atoms. Designs for computer gates with less than the 100,000 atoms have already been proposed. But each atom in such a small device has to be in exactly the right place. To economically build and interconnect trillions upon trillions of such small and precise devices in a complex three-dimensional pattern, we will need a manufacturing technology. Will behind today's lithography, we will need a technology. With it, we should be able to build mass storage device that can store more than 100 billion bytes in a volume the size of the sugar cube. RAM that can store more billion bytes in such a volume and massively parallel computers of the same size that can deliver a billion instructions per second. Military applications. Today, smart weapons are fairly big. We have the smart bomb, but not smart bullet. In the future, even weapon as small as a single bullet could pack more computer power than largest supercomputer in existence today. So that in coming days, we are going to get the smart bombs, smart weapons using the nanotechnology. So that allowing them to perform real-time image analysis of their surroundings and communicate with the weapons tracking system to acquire and navigate the targets with a greater precision and control. By using this nanotechnology, we can track the targets and with the real-time basis, and we can focus the target in a real-time manner so that we can easily collide the target of the weapons. We will also be able to build weapons both expensively and much more rapidly at the same time, taking full advantage of the remarkable materials properties of diamond. So you know that diamond is the hardest material. So the same properties we can achieve by using this nanomaterial. Rapid and inexpensive manufacture of great quantities of stronger, more precise weapons guided by massively increased computational power will alter the way we fight wars. So that total war we can change with this nanotechnology. Changes of this magnitude could destabilize existing power structure in unpredictable ways. Military application of nanotechnology raise a number of concerns that prudence suggests we begin to investigate before rather than after we develop this new technology. So in coming days, by using the nanotechnology, by so many drastic changes will occur in military applications and solar energy. Nanotechnology will cut cost both of solar cell and the equipment needed to deploy them, making solar power economical. In this application, we need not to make new or technically superior solar cells, making inexpensively what we already know how to make expensively would move solar power into the mainstream, so that using the technology we can make the solar power cheaper and easy to use in medical uses. As we discussing, there are so many advantages in medical applications. It is not modern medicine that does the healing, but the cells themselves. We are but onlookers. If we add surgical tools that more molecular both in their size and the precision, we could develop a medical technology that for the first time would let us directly heal the injuries at the molecular and cellular level that are the root causes of disease and ill health. With the precision of the drugs combined with the intelligent guidance of the surgeon's scalpel, we can expect quantum leap in our medical capabilities. So by using the nanotechnology, nanorobots, the medicine will go to the targeted cells and they destroy the bad cells of like cancer, so that we can get rid of the cancer cells and we can cure the cancers by using this nanotechnology. So other advantages of nanotechnology: the problem with the past technology is that they pollute the environment in the cases where human would die in years. The pollution is the big problem, so that by using this nanotechnology we can produce only less pollution. A good example of a bad polluting invention would be the automobile. Automobile ran on gas and the gas fumes destroy the ozone layer, so that this is the we can reduce the pollution by using the nanotechnology. Thank you for watching. This is the important area we discuss. What is the nanotechnology and what is introduction of nanotechnology and nano size and what are the nano materials? The size of the material between 1 to 100 nanometer, it is called the nano size. And also we discussed quantum well, quantum dot, quantum wire, and nanomaterial properties, nanomaterial applications. In the examination, they will ask what is nanomaterial and what is nanotechnology, and define the nanotechnology and what are the properties of nanotechnology and applications of nanotechnology. These questions will come in the examination. If you go through this video, you will be able to answer the all these questions. Thank you for watching. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel, Dr. J.C. Babu, to get the subsequent notification. Thank you.